all too soon, 1 year and 2 months have elapsed since this nation embarked on this huge transformation of facilitating trade and easing the cost and time of doing business at the port of Tema and Takoradi through the paperless port system. Together with stakeholders in the supply chain, we can boast of some modest achievements in this endeavor to turn around the way of doing business at our ports. Looking back prior to 1st of September 2017, we must admit that even though our clearance processes were automated, the cost and time of doing business to the trading public was indeed very expensive. And there were too many duplications of activities and processes. His Excellency, the Vice President's singular initiative to fully automate our ports and transform our systems to a paperless one thus marked the beginning of what we are witnessing today. Indeed, the challenges encountered at the onset were daunting, with the members of the trading community complaining of insufficient public education, the public education of the new system, and the fear of the unknown. However, through the collaborative efforts of the major stakeholders who have to fine-tune their electronic processes and make concessions and sacrifices, we can highlight several successes, such as reducing from 16 port inspection agencies to 3 in the inspection or examination of goods at the ports. We can also highlight the fact that we have reduced the mandatory joint inspection from 100% to about 55% as of October 2018 through the introduction of an integrated risk management system. The removal of the customs long room from the ports to the head office has also helped to eliminate the human interface between officers and trade forwarders. Additionally, the electronic submission of trade documents through the PARS or the PRS system has provided trade forwarders the opportunity to do business within the comfort of their offices and homes without having to commute from one inspection agency to another. This electronic submission has also enhanced error detection and thereby provided input in our audits and investigations procedures. The paperless system has eliminated falsification of hard copies of documents normally presented to trade duties, levies, and other charges. In spite of these successes, there still remain several hurdles to cross. Notable among them are the need to submit credible trade documents in order to reduce queries, which inevitably impede easy and quicker document verification. We still continue to experience occasional downtimes from some of our service providers. One of the areas to seriously consider going forward is the need to continuously improve on capacity building in the area of training for not only customs officers, but for all other agencies equally involved in the supply chain. Logistics improvement will also consolidate the gains made so far in the paperless process. The paperless system has come to stay. It is therefore very imperative that we maintain a positive and progressive mindset in ensuring its sustainability, and thus place Ghana on a higher pedestal in the area of global trade facilitation. On this note, let me seize the opportunity to express our sincere gratitude to all our stakeholders for the effective collaboration and cooperation in our quest to make Ghana the enviable trade hub in the sub-region. Thank you.
For comprehensive statistics on Ghana's maritime industry, visit our website at www.shippers.org.gh, point to publications, and click on Maritime Trade Statistics.